Ah, it's good to be back in Victorian London. A thick fog is beginning to move in gently along each building and cobblestone street. It's getting on towards evening now, and most of the hansom cabs are full and on their way across town. The flickering yellow light of the gas-burning lampposts tries desperately to push back the darkness now as men, women, and children return to the comfort of their homes. My name is Ben Wright, and I have had the pleasure of playing the role of Sherlock Holmes in 1949, and in later years, the role of Dr. John H. Watson. These roles were done on the radio in dramatic presentations that let you, the listener, use your imagination to create, from the mood music, sound effects, and our spoken words, the world that Sir Arthur Conan Doyle devised. When one mentions the name of... there we are. I'll just turn here into Baker Street. I'm sure you know where I'm heading. When you mention the name of Sherlock Holmes or Dr. Watson, most people immediately think of Basil Rathbone and Nigel Bruce as the great detective and his faithful companion. And indeed, when in 1939 Rathbone and Bruce appeared in the classic Hound of the Baskervilles film and did their first Holmes radio show together that same year, Rathbone and Bruce became forever linked as Holmes and Watson. And both men played Holmes and Watson from 1939 continuously until 1946, the same year, incidentally, when they finished their last Holmes film together. And when radio died because of the coming of television, a great medium of entertainment was lost. It was in that medium that Rathbone and Bruce etched the roles of Holmes and Watson in the public mind. 39 weeks a year for 8 years. Ironically, it is in the replaying of the films on television that has kept them alive as the great detective and his companion. The radio shows, having long been thought to be lost. But recently, a large number of the radio shows were discovered, and we are happy to present here, for the first time since they were broadcast in 1945, two of those famous Sherlock Holmes dramas.
This episode from the life of Sherlock Holmes will be transmitted to our men and women overseas by shortwave and through the worldwide facilities of the Armed Forces Radio Service. Petri Wine brings you... Basil Rathbone and Nigel Bruce in the new adventures of Sherlock Holmes. The Petri family, the family that took time to bring you good wine, invite you to listen to Dr. Watson tell us about another exciting adventure he shared with his old friend, that master detective, Sherlock Holmes.
It began on a summer evening in 1906. I'd been for a long walk in the park. I remember when I returned to Baker Street and entered our rooms, Holmes looked up at me with a twinkle and spoke.
You look positively glowing with health, Watson.
Well, I had a splendid walk, my dear fellow. You should have come with me. The park was looking particularly beautiful.
Well, old chap, during your absence, I've decided to write another monograph.
Oh, what's the subject this time?
Occupational liability to murder. For instance, the mortality rate is naturally high among policemen and detectives. Physicians are murdered with fair regularity, but the murder of a dentist is rare. And who ever heard of a murdered veterinary surgeon?
That's quite true, but what's the occasion for this little homily?
I've been browsing over my newspaper clippings.
Yeah?
You recall ever hearing of a murdered tobacconist, Watson?
No, I can't say that I do.
Oh, why? And yet my clippings inform me that no less than three tobacconists have been murdered in the past 6 months, and all the murders have occurred in the same small shop in the East End of London. Now, why do you suppose three tobacconists would be murdered in the same shop? Come now, old fellow. Give me a logical solution to the problem, will you?
Well, now, let me see. You say that the shop's in the East End?
Yes.
Is it near the river?
As it happens, it's on the water's edge.
Then supposing the tobacconist's shop was the headquarters of a smuggling ring. Perhaps boxes of cigars were unloaded from the dock and brought to the shop. Cigars containing pearls or opium or something.
Watson, my dear fellow, you're doing splendidly. What? You must walk in the park more frequently. You're positively scintillating.
Oh, no, you're making fun of me.
I assure you I'm not.
You're expecting anyone home?
No, probably a visitor from Mrs. Hudson. Go on with your fascinating theory. Now, why are three tobacconists murdered?
Well, because they know too much. Perhaps they demand a share in the profits So the head of the ring decides to kill him.
Plausible enough, Watson. I really must congratulate you. Oh. I can see that I'm very lucky in having a biographer with such a lively imagination.
Thanks very much.
Come in.
That's very nice for you. Imagination. Oh, hello, Stroud.
Stroud, I'm glad to see you.
I hope I'm not intruding.
Not at all, my dear fellow. Come along, sit down.
Thank you, Miss Holmes.
Anything remarkable on hand?
No, Miss Holmes. Nothing very particular.
Then tell me all about it, Lestrade.
Can't hide anything from you, can I, sir? Yes, there is something on my mind, and no mistake.
And it concerns the three murdered tobacconists, I see. Splendid.
Now, how the blazes did you know that? Yes, Holmes, that's your message.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.